Hey, we're the cast of Avatar The Last Airbender.
And welcome to our official YouTube after party.
That's right, we're celebrating the brand new trailer of Avatar The Last Airbender.
Right now, we're gonna rewatch the trailer and break it down for you. Roll it.
The Fire Nation is embarked on a dark path. And the world might never recover. The world needs the Avatar.
Look at that.
This was actually like the first few days of filming, wasn't it?
It was the first day.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
No biggie. Not a big scene or anything to start out.
You got straight to it. They were throwing you guys in. They were like, no warm up. You guys are ready.
To tell you the truth, with visual effects, I can't even remember where I was. I think that could have also been the first day, though, because I remember standing on a platform.
That and was them shooting like fake snow at me.
That was nice for you though, to take a little nap, right?
Yeah.
Not a nap, because there's like, bang! Like I'm there,
yeah,
I'm
that's
like,
right.
Oh yeah.
I remember if for that ice scene, if fans remember how we get there, it's a little bit of a journey.
Yeah.
And it was first day of set, and Michael's like, do some push-ups. Like, you want to really seem like you're out of breath. So I did like 150 push-ups that day, like trying to like get myself out of breath while we're like tumbling around and like, ugh.
I also do feel like because it was our first day and like we all had only known each other for like a few weeks before that, I feel like our relationship, even like all as cast, like you could see it bloom, you can see our chemistry get stronger. And so I do feel like our siblingness, it grows.
Yeah, totally.
The Fire Nation has destroyed everything in their path.
Come on.
If the world is gonna have any chance, it's gonna need Aang.
You were looking at Darren.
Right. There goes the savior of the world.
I love that part.
I love comedy stuff. So like every day on set, I was trying to like find different ways to like integrate that into our scripts and like try to enhance it however way I could.
And it's also difficult to try to adapt the comedy in the animated series and then translate that into live action.
Yeah, totally. Because it's like a different type of humor sometimes. Right. Like sometimes in the animated show, they're doing stuff that like literally you physically can't do, like, you know, running around and like doing six backflips and like falling on your head in the snow and then Sokka just like walks away from it. So it was cool to like try to integrate comedy any possible place and way we could.
In the cartoon, Aang was wild. Like he's goofy, he's like funny, he's like really young, but a lot of his stuff was just like really animated. So it was difficult to like bring his happiness into it and at the same time, make this a serious with funny aspects to it.
I chased down every hint of the Avatar. It's my destiny.
Yes! Come on, Paul.
I'm not someone who can stop the Fire Nation.
That's
so
scary.
Menacing.
That's scary.
So menacing.
Seeing very large chest, perfect cheekbones and jawline, biceps that are about to break those bands on his arms. Yeah, you're seeing Ozai do a really cool fire blast, and then Zuko sort of, he's not bending it, he's blocking it, but it's not, it's going like around him. Mm. That part like is honestly kind of scary though, I feel like, intimidating Daniel Day-Kim. And then me playing like a younger version of Zuko, there wasn't a whole lot of acting involved because him with his shirt off, you know, acting like he's gonna punch you in the face is enough for me to get into character.
I don't want the responsibility.
You don't have to do this alone. You have me, Katara.
I love that.
And a flying ball of
fur. What more do you need?
Momo looks so good.
I know.
I would be intimidated. I
June
would be
killed
a little.
It.
I was intimidated. She'd walk around on set. I'd have ACs there. She'd walk by and be like, oh man.
What Jabbar did a great job with that.
Yeah.
Our VFX team was awesome.
Yes.
The world needs you.
Yes. Oh my gosh.
I know him too.
This is the
terrifying.
This is my favorite episode, guys.
Yeah.
I remember sneaking into like the FX office and seeing the picture of him on the wall and just like chills, like, hey, bye.
You know, so many people were worried about how they're gonna make Hei-Bai look real, but when I see this, it's like,
oh my gosh,
that looks real. Yeah. That's scary.
Yeah.
You can tell they really took their time.
Yes.
Totally.
Working on this.
Remember what it is we're really fighting for.
Oh my gosh.
I miss Ken.
The ones we love.
Working and doing this scene was like really fun. There were a lot of like crazy stunts we had to do. I mean, the fight scenes were so intricate and so wild.
Bang, that's my moment. Oh. I was like, everybody else got like oceans rising and like fire sparks. This is my moment. Right, check it out. Boop. Boom.
Dude, there is a fire spark in there.
and there was a little spark. He's about to use that against me too. That's a crazy thing. I think it looks better than some other earthbending we've seen in the past. I'll say that.
Wow. Utkarsh was so amazing to work with. He is like the coolest guy.
Yeah. I was such a huge fan from Pitch Perfect. Whenever I saw him, I was freaked out a little bit. He was always my favorite Treble.
I love this commitment to the role though.
Yes.
Seriously.
Yes.
And he was such like, he was really helpful because at times I would always crack because of how like good he was at being Bumi. Mm-hmm. Like I remember he was doing this thing, walking like in character, and he's just like, hey. It's the funniest thing, and it was so, he was so serious, and it looked so good, but I couldn't stop cracking, and he was always there, like, saying, like, Gordon, you got this, I believe in you.
Yes, this looks so sick.
Wow.
I mean, it's kind of hard to visualize. I think it takes a lot of energy to visualize what you're actually doing on the day. So to see it all come together, it's, like, really magical. It's just stunning. This is like our first little peek at Jet and his sick fighting. I mean, he's got the two hook swords we all know and love. Yeah, this was really cool to shoot. I think this is in between Katara becoming a master and like she's still kind of figuring out her stuff. She's got the basics down, so I feel like this was like her first kind of step into like a fighting zone with not her like regular crew.
The arrow tattoos, I knew they're gonna like light them up, but I wasn't sure if they're gonna like light up the design or not.
Oh,
mm.
Yeah, like the small really little detail, cool intricate details.
Yep. And the glowing on the outside is so cool.
Yeah.
It's very sick.
This is like almost exactly how I pictured it. That's the wild thing.
Yeah.